Hello students, welcome back to our channel. Okay, today I have come with another topic, that is on parallel combination of capacitors. In previous video I did series combination of capacitors, so today I have come with parallel combination of capacitors. So these two derivations are very important, definitely for 3 marks questions, definitely they are going to ask, so get practiced. Okay, so what happens if you connect parallelly, what is parallel combination, we'll see it, and then finally we derive the expression for effective capacitance of a parallel combination of capacitors. Okay, then get started. So I already have written here so that to save the time. Okay, a number of capacitors are said to be in parallel. Okay, yavagu parallel alli irthave avag yenagutte parallel combination andre eno, parallel connection andre eno anta tilad barutte illi. If they are connected between two common terminals, see what is parallel connection. Here is the diagram, you can just see the one end of the capacitor is taken and connected to a common terminal. This A is a common over here, then second capacitor do kuda ondu plate ina the ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಎ. ಸೊ ಇ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬೋತ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಬೋತ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಅ ಕಾಮನ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಲರ್ ಸಾರಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಲರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ okay or parallel combination. What happens if you do parallel combination or parallel connection? In this case the potential difference across each capacitor remains same. In series it was getting divided, whereas in parallel it is same. And what is getting divided here? Charges are getting divided. So the charge supplied to the combination is equal to what? Sum of the charges across the individual capacitor. That means when charges are given, here Q1 amount of charges are accumulated and here Q2 amount of charges are accumulated. That means as I add these two, then I get what? Total charge supplied to this combination. Okay. So with this result, we'll derive the expression for effective capacitance of a parallel combination. Okay, so this is the diagram. See, I told you what is effective capacitance. Again, I'm repeating that if two or more capacitors are connected to a battery, then those two capacitor will act like a one single capacitor. And here since it is a parallel combination, so this one single capacitor I have represented like this, that is CP. So what is CP here? CP is a equivalent capacitance, you can see, or effective capacitance of parallel combination anta helabodu. Okay, so we need to find the CP now. Okay, so we know that the charge supplied to the combination is equal to what? Sum of charges across individual capacitor. So it is a Q equal to Q1 plus Q2 I can write. Let me take this as equation 1 now. Okay. Exactly. But what is the definition of capacitance of a capacitor? Q by V. So from this expression, can I get Q expression? Q equal to what is it? CV, correct. By knowing this expression, can I find Q1 and Q2? Exactly. So here what will be our Q1? By this definition, this implies Q1 equal to, Q1 is of first capacitor, so C1 into V. Here V is same. And what about Q2? Q2 is equals to C2 into V, that is second capacitor. So this two equations I'll consider as equation number 2 and this as equation 1. Now can I put 2 in 1 to get the total charge supplied to this combination, right? So therefore Q is equals to C1V plus C2V. Q2 equals to VL ticket as common C1 plus C2 exactly right okay I'll mention this as equation number 3 now I need to find what is CP if CP is the equivalent capacitance of parallel combination then how we are going to define CP by this diagram CP is equals to what your total charge is how much Q by V isn't it so CP is equals to Q by V okay from this equation can I get Q value right so can I get Q value from this equation so therefore Q is equals to CP into V this I'll mention as equation number 4 now can I put 4 in 3 exactly so by putting 4 in 3 what do you get Q is CP V equal to V into C1 plus C2 okay V goes off so CP equals to C1 plus C2 so this is the expression for equivalent capacitance so how we are going to define now we are going to define this as the equivalent capacitance of parallel combination of capacitor is defined as the sum of the capacitance of individual capacitor sum of capacitance of individual capacitor is called as effective capacitance of parallel combination okay so that's all in this video today's video I hope you understood this derivation right thank you so much